Well, here I am in my little house on the hillside in the suburbs of San Diego. This is my patio, and this is my cell phone and my tequila. Oh, yeah. And here's the house. It's still quite an enlightened day. You can see over there, sunlight shining on the trees and the bushes. It's left the swimming pool behind. It's now moving up. The light is moving up and the shadows coming up behind it as the sun goes down. I'm still not quite used to living here. It's probably going to take a long time for me to get used to living here. I mean, I lived here and I listened to the cars driving by on the road for many years. We lived nearby from 1953 to 1959, about a mile away, around and down the hill and on another hill over there. That house had only two bedrooms. I got to have one and my parents had the other, and we had one bathroom. And the whole time, my parents were trying for another baby. They wanted to have two babies. My mother had three miscarriages. I only remember the last one. I was six when she lost a baby, and I knew something really sad had happened. It took a couple years for me to figure out that she'd lost a baby. I think about the time my brother was actually born, when I was eight, I realized what had happened 2 years before, is that my mother had lost a baby. And then many years later, I learned she'd lost two more before that, but I hadn't known about them. I was younger. I was four. Three, and I didn't know what she had gone through. Anyhow, that time we were living in a small house about a mile from here, down the canyon and around the hill, in the same watershed. I seem to have a nasty cough, and I'm a little bit worried, but we'll have to wait and see if I've got the deadly disease or not. If I do die quickly from the plague, I want you all to know that I have enjoyed knowing all of you. Ones that I've disagreed with and the ones I've agreed with. We have been together in this community of video loggers as different sites we've shared on. I think my favorite is, no, I'm not gonna say what my favorite is. I like them all. But basically, I put my videos up on Vimeo, YouTube, Vloggerheads, and Vloasis. Did you hear the bird? I'm very lucky. I have good fortune to have a home. Even if the cars drive by on the road and make noise in the afternoon, coming home, even if the airplanes go by overhead, because there's a small airport about 2 miles from here. There's an airport in El Cajon where the little planes go to land. There, I can hear one. That's about the only bothersome noise we have here. Cars and trucks on the road and airplanes in the sky. Other than that, it's very quiet here in this house. As I was saying, we lived from 1953 to 1959. Down the watershed and around the corner where the creek bends south and goes down towards down towards the Sweetwater River. We lived on another hill from 1953 to 1959, and the whole time, pretty much the whole time, my parents were looking for the next house because they knew they wanted to have another baby. And that we'd need at least 3 bedrooms. I don't think they ever wanted to have more than 2 children. This is a little bothersome, especially in these days of the plague. I'll just have to wait 14 days and see if I caught anything. I suppose I could go get a test, but I really don't want to. Anyhow, I'm living in this house. My mother and my father, may they rest in peace. And my brother, who's still quite alive. And I. Me, myself, and I. We moved from the little house with 2 bedrooms and 1 bathroom on the hillside a mile away. We moved from there at the end of January 1959, and we moved into this house. This house is for me the American dream. It has 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, and a garage. It has a laundry room, a kitchen, dining room, living room. Simple house, but big, especially for one person. I've been living here alone since July. It's now November. I've been here 4 months. Came here on July 25th. It's now November 27th. I've been here 4 months. And even that, although it seems to me a long time, even that is very small compared to the years that I lived here. My mother lived here from January of 1959 until May of 1978. Just about 20 years she lived here. In 1977, my father died. In 1978, my mother remarried a man who had wanted to marry her in 1942, but the war interfered, and my mother met my father and married him instead. But he died, and my stepfather, who had been married but lost his wife 3 years before after having three children, my stepfather got a Christmas card from my mother that year and began to court her. And so my mother left this house when she married my stepfather. When he asked her to marry him, she said, "May I bring my son," meaning my younger brother. He said, "Yes." "May I bring my dog," because she had a Saint Bernard that was about 3 years old. And he said, "Yes." "And may I bring my loom," because my mother was a weaver, and she had a big loom, and it would need a whole room just to sit in. Well, my stepfather said, "Yes." So my mother left this house in 1978, and it took about a year to get the house ready, but eventually she rented it. And this house was rented from 1979 until 2021. That's 79 to 89 is 10 years, 89 to 99 is 20 years, 99 to 09 is 30 years, and 2009 to 2019 is 40 years. This house was rented to renters for 42 years, from 1979 to 2021. And now, the man who was a boy here is living here. And soon my brother will be living here when he retires in 3 or 4 years. I'm alone here. I like being alone, but today's Saturday, day before yesterday was Thursday, Thanksgiving. I did not want to be alone. I did not want to be alone on Thanksgiving. And fortunately, I had the good fortune of receiving an invitation from my friend and his wife to have Thanksgiving dinner Thursday night before last with them and their son and his girlfriend. And so I did. It was good. Only five of us. We didn't have to worry about who was going to talk when, because we just naturally flowed from one to another. My old friend, who I've known since 1971, and his wife, whom he married back around 1985, I think it was, 40 some years ago, maybe 30 something years ago. They were not expecting to have a child, but they did. Suddenly, a few years later, my friend discovered that his wife was telling him something. And he stopped and listened, and he realized that they were going to be parents. And so their son was born about 25 years ago. And he's now a graduate from UCSD, which is coincidentally where I went to school for 6 years. No, 7 years. And the five of us sat around and talked about genealogy and all kinds of stuff. It was wonderful. But it's not going to happen next year because my brother and his wife, although we couldn't get together this year, they told me, was it this morning or was it, I believe it was yesterday evening, Friday. My brother called and we talked about all kinds of stuff, about the property taxes for this house, which are due in December, and all kinds of stuff. And one of them was that they want to have Thanksgiving dinner here next year. So, you hear the road? Yeah. Well, as I'm sitting here, the sun is sinking down, but it's still lighting up the bushes over there. It comes in from which way? From that way. Yeah, from over that way. It comes in through a gap in the mountain. And this time of year, the sun shines through the gap in the mountain into the canyon here. So it's very quiet here. Occasionally, and especially in the mornings and the late afternoons, there'll be traffic on the road. Sometimes a plane comes by overhead, either a small plane from the little airport nearby, or sometimes a larger airplane from the big airport in San Diego. Sometimes they turn over the mountains here and you can hear the big jets calling. Well, evidently it wasn't anything important. But sometimes when it goes chirp, it means there's a new picture of the grandson. The baby. Anyhow, it's getting on. I only have 26 minutes left on the battery, so I just wanted to get on, say hi, and tell you how my American Thanksgiving was. And a lot of you have autumn festivals, maybe not on the same day as the United States, but it's a pretty universal thing to have a celebration of the autumn and the harvest. So I hope you are all well. And if you had Thanksgiving here in the United States or anywhere else on the day before yesterday, I hope things went well and you didn't have too many family melodramas. We will now that in the United States, now that Thanksgiving is gone by, day before yesterday, we'll now be getting into the holidays of Christmas, New Year's. Hanukkah is early this year. So I wish you the blessings of the Festival of Light, as well as any holy days you celebrate and keep. Soon it will be another year. But until then, it's still the same old year. Plague, war, financial insecurity, you know, the usual suspects. Yeah. My love to you all, and best wishes. May you vlog on.